There are a few terms like normality, molarity, molality. These terms are confused a lot. Let's discuss normality in first place. Then I'll be discussing molarity and molality as well. Normality is, as we go for the definition of this, it is defined as gram equivalent weight of solute per liter of solution. Let's go into the main formula and the representation of this very definition. Normality. It is the gram equivalent weight of solute per liter of solution. Now the question arises that what is gram equivalent weight? Okay, let's discuss gram equivalent weight. We have to explore this formula, you know. Like, it is not okay for us to say that this is the formula and go for the answer of a particular question. We have to first explain the entire thing so that this formula is easy to dissect and to know. Okay, so what is gram equivalent weight of solute? It is this way. Gram equivalent weight of solute is equal to weight of solute that is measured in grams by equivalent weight of solute. Okay, now this equivalent weight of solute is measured in gram per equivalent. Okay, now the problem arises that what is equivalent weight of solute? Okay, now let's go and dissect this formula. Equivalent weight of solute. Now this is the final thing which will lead us to the final formula. Equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by charge on cation or anion. Okay, so once we have gone through these basic formulas, we are going to dissect the main formula. Okay, as we have already explained and dissected the formula of normality, now we are going to write it in a very descriptive form. Instead of writing gram equivalent weight of solute divided by liter of solution, I am going to write it as weight of solute in gram divided by equivalent weight of solute, gram per equivalent multiplied by volume of solution. Okay, there is another formula for normality as well, in which we are going to convert liter into milliliter. Technically, converting liter into milliliter, at times it's very difficult to remember that what exact operation one has to do for conversion of liter into milliliter. Yes, I made a trick ke liter ko milliliter mein karte hain to kya karte hain aur milliliter ko liter mein karte hain to kya karte hain. Jab kisi choti cheez ko badi cheez mein karenge tab bhi koi aisa hi operation karenge jo usko chota kare, jo hame bazaahir lagta hai ki wo chota karta hai usko. तो डिवीजन एक ऐसा ऑपरेशन होता है जो कि कोई किसी भी चीज़ को छोटा कर देता है, ठीक है, कम कर देता है. तो व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू कन्वर्ट मिलीलीटर इनटू लीटर, वी आर गोइंग टू डिवाइड इट बाय 1000. ओके, व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू कन्वर्ट लीटर इनटू मिलीलीटर, वी आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 1000. लीटर इज ऑलरेडी अ वेरी बिग थिंग एंड वी आर गोइंग टू मल्टीप्लाई इट, इट लुक्स एज इफ वी आर गोइंग टू मेकिंग इट बिग अगैन to convert it into milliliter. So over here, this formula, this volume of solution that is in a liter is going to be converted into milliliter. So the formula comes out to be weight of solute in grams divided by equivalent weight of solute multiplied by volume of solution in milliliter. Okay, when we are going to take volume of solution in milliliter, we are going to multiply the entire thing with 1000. Okay, so these are the three formulas that are continuously used in every numerical. One has to understand the formulas to make it very comprehensible and easy for you to solve the numericals. Okay, in the next video I will be explaining some of the numericals so that you can understand the usage of these formulas. Also I will be giving you some homework, so you know, next video is very important for you to take.